The idea behind joining politics is, for me, politics is worship. It is at the end of the day, politicians who change destiny of people, destiny of states, destiny of world. They decide policies, no matter how brilliant a bureaucrat may be, but the policy making in the democratic setup lies with the politicians. So you can change the system only when you will reach at a position where from you can at least contribute something and make the system to change. That's why I joined politics. And more importantly, in 1990, I was a student of the university when militancy erupted. From that day to this day, we are not coming out of all this what people of Jammu and Kashmir have gone through. So I faced a lot of miseries in my life. I am a resident of Kupwara district, you may be knowing it. There was oppression and suppression from all sorts. And for that reason only, after fighting for human rights of the people, their legitimate rights in my area, people of the constituency, Langit, where from I come up, they, on their desire, I left the government job. I was having a very wonderful government career, government employee career. So I gave that profession up and joined the politics. And thanks God, from that time to this time, I am in politics for around from 2008 to 2024, 16 years. I have been a lawmaker for 10 and a half years and 5.5 years in Tihar Jail. So I am ready to give account of my every single day. And let those people who are lying Kashmiris, making false and fake promises, let them tell why Kashmiri chit to this position. They have to be accountable for 70 years of miseries which Kashmiris are still facing.
You talked about Tihar, so your slogan Tihar ka badla vote se is resonating with many people. So how do you plan to address the concerns of those who feel victimized by the system?
Obviously, you have to get up against the system which has let you down, which is bulldozing your rights. So if you are in Tihar, it is not your weakness, it is your strength. If I was in Tihar, it is my strength, because despite all the state machinery against me, all the institutions against me, people voted for me, because nobody can suppress the people and nobody can go and check to whom they vote. At this, there is that much of legitimacy to the system settled there. So I think that is the main reason.
Sympathy votes or,
No, not at all. I have been working, I have already told you, I have answered the question. In 1989, I raised my voice against human rights violation. I was sent to jail in 2005. I spent months in Central Jail, Srinagar, in 2006. So from that day to this date, my everyday has been a struggle. I owe it to my people. I owe it to my conscience. And having said that, let me make one point clear, that the day I was elected MLA, I tried to keep the balance between the sentiment and the development. I didn't ignore the day-to-day needs of Kashmiri people. I can tell you that during my 11 years of being a public representative for Langit constituency, out of all the 87 constituencies J&K had, I took maximum share for developmental schemes and projects to Langit constituency. I asked people that while seeking your rights, you should not forget your duties. I was the only man. You can see in my manifesto also, I didn't prompt it for fake electricity. I want to make people that they should become morally emboldened. They should become, their character should be displayed and people should read it, that these Kashmiris, they are not beggars, we don't need mercy. And it was a vote to the work which I did for the people of Langit, and it was also a vote for the sentiments which I represented on their behalf in the assembly, inside the assembly, and it was a vote to the atrocities which Narendra Modi did with me and with every Kashmiri on 5th of August 2019 by abrogating Article 370. So it was a vote to the people's commitment that Modi's Naya Kashmir is not acceptable to us.
So there are allegations from the opposite parties that you are a BJP proxy. So how do you respond to that?
I wonder why you're asking me this question. besides being a journalist, you are a human being. Have some pity on me. I am the only one who was victimized by BJP. All these other people, you are forcing me to speak. Rather, they are forcing me to speak. They were kept in SKICC for 4 or 5 months on EWAP abrogation of Article 370. You know it better. 3 crore 60 lakhs is the official report, which is the expenditure for keeping those white elephants there, because they were hand in gloves with Narendra Modi. I was the only MLA who was sent to Tihar. Tell me, for God's sake, was I afraid of anyone that they sent me to Tihar? Surgery bhi hui, sab kuch hua. 5.5 saal wahan diye. My aunt died, my mausi died. I have seen my parents yesterday after 5.5 years. They are not able to listen or even to see me properly. They are in their 80s. And people should feel ashamed who say me. I mean those people. I'm a BJP proxy. And Umar has been with BJP. PDP has launched it. It has acted like a launching pad of BJP. And more importantly, why BJP will need Kashmiris? BJP has already fulfilled this agenda. If now somebody takes cudgels with the center, he will have to get all those things back which ancient PDP gifted to them, be it Article 370, 35A or 53 status.
So what is your stance on Article 370 or Kashmiri Pandit's meditation?
My stand on Article 370 is clear. For me, resolution of Kashmir issue is main important, but Modi ji tried to change the goalpost by abrogating Article 370. I have to get restored Article 370, but that does not mean that Kashmir issue is resolved. When Article 370 was there, Kashmir issue was settled there. When Article 370 will be reinstated, it will be settled there. If it is not reinstated, Kashmir is settled there. India is itself asking Pakistan that shun the violence, we will talk to you. So if India really means its words, then it will have to restore Article 370 and talk to the all stakeholders for resolution of Kashmir issue. Article 370 has done nothing except silencing Kashmiris at the pellet of the gun, Modi trying to mislead people of India. How they have led down Modi. He asked for 370 seats in Parliament. He said that because I have abrogated Article 370, give me 370 seats. But people of India didn't like it. They gave him 240 seats. So it means that hats off to people of India, common people of India, who didn't got trapped in Modi's narrative on Article 370. The rest is the media hype which Modi gave it. Then you said me that what was the next question? You put three questions. Political scenario, you see it. For 5.5 years, Umar Sahab was playing golf in Gulmarg, enjoying his holidays in London. He never gave a peaceful call against abrogation of Article 370. He could neither become Gandhi nor Subhash Chandra Bose, and neither Mahbub Musi could become Razia Sultana nor could he become Aung San Suu Kyi or Burma. So they are puppets, they are rubber stamps. What are you expecting from them? The political scenario is that in the mainstream, I have to speak for myself, who will speak for me? I am the only man in the mainstream who is there in Tihar jail and asking Modi, tere haathun mein wo lakeer nahi hai, Kashmir kisi ke baap ki jaagir nahi hai. So political narratives, you are seeing it. I was in jail, I settled, won the election by more than 2 lakh votes. And then you said that, Umar Saab said that, I am a BJP proxy. People have given them mandate, people have reminded him of his birth. So he should feel some shame. Had I been the BJP's mandate, why he had to beg in Gandharbal? For God's sake, it is a question of my honor, dignity, give me this seat. Now he is begging for becoming an MLA after getting badly beaten there. Though I never enjoyed his defeat, because at the end of the day, he is son of the soil. I have respect for him. But he should introspect that why people didn't vote against for him.
So you said in your rally that Umar Abdullah, Mehbooba Mufti would ask Kejriwal, when he gets bail or something, they would visit him. But they have not visited him.
Wonderful. You put a very good question. See, Kejriwal is in cage just for a few months. And when his madam and Himat Soren, his madam, they organized public rallies, these people participated there. You know it, it's everything on record. How can they be fooled, Kashmiris? These people participated that Kejriwal should be released, they are innocent, but they never, never spoke even a single word, not for me, leave, let me go to hell. Did they ever spoke for Huriyat? Did they ever spoke for the youth who are lying in jails since more than decades? They just wanted to score political points. So they spoke for Kejriwal and Soren, who were arrested in alleged bribery cases. Anyway, they are, he's out, I enjoy, I am good. Hats off to Kejriwal, I salute him, I congrats him. But tell me, Umar Saab has to take care of first his whom? But ask him, how tragic. Today, Kejriwal gets bail, they must be feeling happy. India, entire India block, especially their Kashmiri puppets. But he is saying, why Indian Rishi has got an interim bail after 5.5 years. Shame on Umar Abdullah. And Mahbuba Mufti also. I am blunt. Some people say me during my speeches, Facebook, engineer, sub-speech, blunt. Dil jala hu na. Dil jala hu. Main hi janta hu. Tihar mein kis tarah maine Kashmiri ki laashen dekhi. Altaf Phantosh Gilani sahab ka sanallah. Mere saath se, he was in cell with me for 2.5 years. And I took his dead body. Raat ke andhere mein dafan ho gayi. I saw what happened to people in Tihar. I saw how we are suppressed there. So I am in pain. Umar Saab, he doesn't, wo to shahzada hai, Gupkar ka shahzada hai.
Sir, aapne charges ki baat ki, Tihar ki baat ki. So you have a serious charge of terror funding. Do you think you are being targeted just for your association?
See, in my bail condition, the one condition put by the Honorable Court is that I should not speak about the case. So I have highest regard for the case, let me not speak it. But I am sure that justice will be done and I will be free and I will be free of all charges.
What are your priorities for
Baramulla
constituency and how will you address
issues?
Wonderful.
Had I not done good work in language, people would not have voted me again and again and again from that place. They voted me in 3 parliament elections, in panchayats, in DDC elections, in assembly elections. So I will ask Modi ji a question. Let you fight me politically. Now, on 4th June, the day I was declared winner from Baramulla constituency, Modi ji had all the powers, his home ministry. They could have withdrawn the case against me in respect and honor to the democracy. Because they claim India is the largest democracy. I say it is the largest democracy only by virtue of numbers. Are you getting to my point? It is the largest democracy by virtue of numbers. 140 million deshvasiyon ka desh. Usme Modi ji bhool gaye ki mata engineer Rashid bhi hai. Having said that, what I want to say, that he should also know that India, being just the largest democracy of the world, is not enough. India has to be a functional and a vibrant democracy. For that, Modi ji has to do a lot. And it would have been a good example if he would have withdrawn the case, respecting the people's mandate. The people of North Kashmir, he should have respected their mandate and asked that let their MP go and represent them. But he didn't do that. But what he tried again get his mileage out of the results from Baramulla election. That people of Baramulla, people of Kashmir have voted this time in high percentage. But he should know it was not a vote to his Naya Kashmir. It was because they voted for Engineer Rashid. And the results are facts speak themselves. So I will humbly ask Modi ji. I am not afraid of jail. I will ask him his own dialogue only, remind him. Daro mat, dara mat. आप मुझे इतना क्यों डरते हैं आप मुझे जेल से बाहर नहीं आने देते. सो इफ ही हैज सम रेस्पेक्ट फॉर डेमोक्रेसी ही शुड अलाउ मी सो दैट आई कैन फाइट फॉर द पीपल ऑफ ए पार्लियामेंट्री कॉन्स्टिट्यूंसी फॉर देयर डेमोक्रेटिक राइट्स पॉलिटिकल राइट्स डेवलपमेंटल राइट्स आई वांट टू मेक बारामूला पार्लियामेंट्री कॉन्स्टिट्यूंसी a model in the entire country where I will try to go and empower people. You just might, there was no media people. People have said that he's doing it only for media. There were few guys. I thought they must be college students in my program. I got them and I banged them there. I told them, your job is in the colleges. Please don't follow me. I am there to speak for you. You try to become even my masters tomorrow and I should take lead from you at some proper time.
Sir, you talked about solving Kashmir issue.
Kamal ki baat hai. Is it a question? I am fighting, ma'am. I am in jail. I am in jail only because I want to solve Kashmir issue. Now how I solve it? Let I have already said there are laid principles. Let the people decide. Rajnath Singh, Modi ji, Amit Shah ji, they are everyday killing POKs. People are ready to come to us. How will they come? They can't break the borders. Let people decide. Let people go and seek a referendum and they will come. Similar will be the case here. Maybe Akhand Bharat dream is fulfilled. Maybe POK is part of India. So if Modi ji has a better solution, let him call us. But not like that when he called leaders of India Alliance and nothing happened. They were just taken for a cup of tea. So if Modi ji has a better resolution, we will listen to him and let us see. Thank you.
Sir, parliamentary elections
mein aaya
affidavit ki jo aapki liabilities
hai,
that have come down drastically.
Yeah.
You were in jail. Wonderful.
Sir, the reasons uski kya hai aur was it a political problem? Really a wonderful question. I read it about it in jail, but what I could do? It was in Economic Times perhaps or Hindustan Times, but PTI was in there. The reason is whatsoever I had reflected as my liabilities in 2019. In 2024, I showed lesser liabilities. The reason is, from 2019 to 2024, I was in jail, but I was a lawmaker. Assembly was dissolved. I could not get my pension because I was in jail. So finally, the jail authorities, I am thankful to them, they cooperated. And finally, it was released in one installment. I received around 30 lakh rupees, or I don't remember exact amount, and some other money also. And I put that all money because I had taken some loan, some rather huge loan from the Jammu and Kashmir Bank. And I deposited that. Automatically they cut, took the installments which were due. They took those installments. So obviously my liabilities became down. So what is the question? They should have confirmed the facts. And I will look at PTI. Please take care of your credibility. PTI has lied too many times. When Devinder Singh was arrested, DSP Devinder Singh. PTI carried the news, engineer she to be questioned in PTI Devinder Singh's case. That I had never in my life seen him. Then I had in my life never met him. And then I was never questioned. So PTI is just what they did, they eroded their credibility. Apni credibility bacha ke rakhi.
Sir, a question hai mera. What sets you apart from other
drama?
What sets you apart from other political?
What?
What sets you apart from other candidates? Jaise baaki race mein hai candidates hai. NC hai, PDP hai, aur, ye
my slogan is aam AIP kya kahe AIP aam aadmi AIP. You force me to understand. I would love to do it here. So for me the important thing is that people deserve the respect. People are the real heroes, and people you see everywhere, especially in the subcontinent, people only talk about their rights. What makes me different is that I want people that take care of your duties. Let you pay the electric bills and then let you see 24 hours electricity. Let you pay the taxes whatsoever. For me, everyone also. Yes, if there are some disparities, we can always talk about them, about our rights. Thank you.
Thank you.
Shukriya.
सर आपने कल उमर रैली में कहा कि उमर अब्दुल्ला, मैं मानूंगा कि अगर उमर अब्दुल्ला मेरे साथ तिहार जेल तक मुझे साथ आएंगे, उमर अब्दुल्ला ने आपका चैलेंज एक्सेप्ट किया है, वो कह रहे हैं कि ठीक है हम आपके साथ आएंगे, कि वुड यू क्विट पॉलिटिक्स?
मेरे तो वैसे ही क्विट किए हैं, आई एम नॉट इन पॉलिटिक्स। लोगों ने फार्म भरा, लोगों ने पैसे खर्च किए, आज भी लोग ही कर रहे हैं। आई एम नॉट इन पॉलिटिक्स। इन पॉलिटिक्स उमर साहब इज दियर, मैडम इज दियर, सजाद लोन इज दियर, अदर्स आर दियर, बिकॉज दियर वन पॉइंट आई नॉट ग्रह पावर बाई हुक और कुक। जितना पहले मुझे पता है उमर साहब की किस बात का भरोसा करें, जब 370 हटा, कहने टाक उर्दू आसो ताकि बाकी लोग सुने, जब 370 हटा जेल गए, उसके बाद जेल के अंदर से दाढ़ी बनाकर फोटो भेज दी, जेल नहीं गए सॉरी इधर एसकेआईसी में थे, तो उसके बाद जब बाहर निकले तो कहा कि किसी हिंदुस्तान की नेशनल पार्टी ने हमारे लिए कुछ नहीं बोला, यू मस्ट बी विटनेस टू इट। फिर जब निकले तो भाग गए इंडिया अलायंस के साथ। उसके बाद जब मोदी जी ने बुलाया दिल से दूरी, दिल्ली से दूरी खत्म करनी है, गए वहां पर, उमर साहब भी मैडम भी, क्या क्या बताऊं, मुझे टाइम होता मैं पूरा कौम को बता देता, कश्मीरी समझदार हैं वहां। फिर कहा कि आजाद साहब हमारे ब्याह पर बात करेगा, इफ यू रिमेम्बर, डू यू रिमेम्बर आर नॉट, आजाद कहा आजाद साहब बात करेगा मोदी जी के साथ ऑल पार्टी मीटिंग में
जी।
कहा आजाद साहब, इसको मैडम ने भी कहा ही कहा, वेल ही वॉज नॉट पार्ट ऑफ गुप्कार अलायंस। उसके बाद जब लगा कहीं कहीं आजाद साहब को पूछ नहीं करें सीएम, फिर कहा आजाद भी गद्दार है। फिर जब मैंने इलेक्शन लड़ा, मेरे बच्चों ने इलेक्शन लड़ा, तो आपने पढ़ा होगा कहा इंजीनियर रशीद को सजा लोने बंद करवाया, और लेकिन जब मैं जीत गया फिर कहा इट इज विक्ट्री ऑफ इस्लामिस्ट एंड रेडिकल्स। आई आंसर जस्ट दैट एन मुस्लिम कैन नीदर बी एन इस्लामिस्ट, एंड मैंने कहा आई एम प्राउड टू बी इस्लामिस्ट बट ए मुस्लिम कैन नेवर बी रेडिकल, आई एम प्राउड टू बी इस्लामिस्ट। लेकिन तीन दिन गुजरे, फिर कहीं लगा असेंबली इलेक्शन होने वाला है, तो रूमर चला है बीजेपी का प्रॉक्सी है। उसके बाद कहा उसको तो बेल मिलेगी, कोर्ट का फैसला है, फारूक साहब के खिलाफ भी ईडी ने चार्ज कैंसिल किया, उस वक्त कोर्ट ने किया, अब जब मुझे बेल मिली उसको कोर्ट ने क्या रिलीज किया, उसकी किस बात का बुरो गया, वो तो खानदानी तौर से एक चीटर है शेख साहब से लेकर, जिसने इस कौम को दफन किया, सबसे ज्यादा बुरबाद अगर मैं किसी गया मरहूम शेख महबूबुल्लाह ने किया, सारी मुसीबतों की जड़ तो शेख साहब है, फिर जो बचा था वो अब उस बाप बेटा पूरा करना।